Hey guys, welcome back to React Bootstrap YouTube series. If you like to see more videos like this, please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. Alright, now without any further delay, let's get started. In this video, we'll be discussing and implementing the React Bootstrap component alert. React Bootstrap provides easy and customizable alerts that we can import directly into our React app. Now let's have a look at the code. You can see that the documentation provides names like primary, secondary, success, danger, warning, info, dark, light. These are nothing but just the color names. Like primary is for blue color, secondary is for this grayish color, and so on. And they are mapping over this, like they are looping over the color names. And this is the actual alert tag that we will also import in our React app. This gets imported and the names of the color are added inside the variant tag over here. Let's scroll down and see what else the documentation has. Alert.link is another tag that can be used inside the alert tag. It is used to provide a link inside an alert like this. Now let's have a look at its code. It is the same thing that I explained before. The only difference is they've used an alert.link tag inside the alert tag. And this provides the link that we can see over here. Let's scroll down. This is just another example of an alert. Now, you also may want to create a dismissible alert like this. When you click on the cross, the alert goes away. So we can also do that using React Bootstrap. And we can see that they have provided us some code that executes this. Now let's break down this code. They have created a function called alert dismissible example. Inside this, they have used React hooks. UState is a React hook. It basically helps in showing and setting the show to true and false. After this, we can see that there is an if condition. If show is true, then this executes. And we can see that we have our alert tag inside this with a variant of danger, which is basically the red color that you can see here. And it also has an onClose method. Inside the onClose method, we can see that there is another function which returns setShow, and it sets it to false. This is what actually closes our alert. We can also see that after this, there is another parameter written as dismissible. This does nothing, but it creates a cross in our alert. After that, there is a heading tag where our heading goes, and a paragraph tag, the body, and then the alert closes. In the end, we can see that there is a button, which is also a React button. It is basically the button that fires the alert. This blue button that you can see over here, its code is this. So now let's copy this code and try it in our own editor. We will not copy the render method because we already have it defined in our own index.js file. Now let's go back to our editor. I'll remove this function and paste what we copied. And I have imported alert already. Since we are also using the useState hook, so we'll import it from React like this. We are also using the React Bootstrap button, so we'll also need to import it. Let's save a file and run the script. It is loading. It usually takes less than a minute. And we have an error saying app is not defined. This error is because we haven't changed our export default. Let's change it to this. Let's copy this and paste it over here. Now let's go and see our alert. And here is our alert. It is also dismissible. Let's click on the cross and it goes away. And this is the button. Let's click on show alert and the alert comes. Also, let's open our developer tools and we can see that the alert is responsive. It changes its width according to the viewport. And this goes for all the React components, React Bootstrap components that we are gonna see in the coming videos. All right, thank you guys. This is it for this video. Maybe it's 3 a.m. Had you on my mind, and it's not the first time we've gone through this. Tell me pretty lies, look me in the face, tell me that you love.